The National Health Insurance Authority is set to owe Christian health facilities 87 million Ghana cedis covering the months of March to November 2019. Bishop of Koforidua, the Most Reverend Joseph Efrifaija Kumb, says in some cases, outstanding claims span some months in 2018 and with some remnants of arrears from 2017 as well. The Ghana Medical Association, in a statement issued on Friday, 21st of February 2020, raised serious concerns of a government's failure to properly pay the national health insurance claims to these health facilities across the country. The Health Insurance Service Providers Association of Ghana has meanwhile threatened to withdraw some of its services from March 2020 if the arrears owed its members by government through the National Health Insurance Scheme is not paid. This afternoon, I've been joined by Dr. James Dia, who is the Deputy Executive Director of the Christian Health Association of Ghana, joining us. Good afternoon, sir. Thank you very much. And we're told that as much as government owes you, some of your members have been disconnected power. Tell us about it.
Right. Thank you very much. And good afternoon to your viewers.
Good afternoon.
The Electricity Corporation of Ghana and the NETCO have disconnected most of our institutions in BA. As you are aware, the Christian Health Association of Ghana facilities complement the services of government facilities. And in particular, in BA, majority of the facilities belong to CHAG. And so it is quite disturbing that the Electricity Corporation of Ghana should go ahead and disconnect. Well, this is the first time I'm seeing hospitals as essential services being disconnected from electricity. Majority of our services rely on electricity. Theater, where we do surgeries, and especially these days we are talking about maternal mortality, yeah. And Ghana has come a very long way
in dealing with that crisis.
Now you have a state institution going around disconnecting not residences but essential service areas. That is quite disturbing. So some of our facilities, let me mention one of them. Doma Presby Hospital has since yesterday been disconnected. The situation
and
is
this is for indebtedness to ECG. So why is the hospital not paying its indebtedness, or the indebtedness are supposed to be paid by the Ministry of Health?
Well, some time ago government used to pay the electricity bills. Remember, CHAG is a subvented organization. We receive government support, and we are very grateful to government. We've been receiving the support for many years. For some few years now, that support is not coming. And we are hoping that, it will continue, that support comes and we are not disconnected. But we find it quite worrying that for the past couple of weeks, our facilities are being disconnected.
So what have you done about it? I mean, have you made an appeal to government in light of the fact that you are owed huge sums of money? Perhaps if this amount is paid, you could still go ahead and service your indebtedness to the ECG. Have you made any overtures to government to try and resolve this problem?
Yes, we are working with the Ministry of Health. For the past couple of days, our executive director has been talking to the Minister of Health to help address the issue. But the main issue is that we are also owned by National Health Insurance Scheme, as you said, from March.
The tune of 87 million.
87 million. We want to plead with Electricity Corporation of Ghana not to disconnect facilities, because it will be a death sentence. Mothers who have to have cesarean session can die. We have neonatal intensive care units that are disconnected, accidents that are happening. All equipment that rely on electricity cannot be operated. More so, vaccines and medicines that require good temperatures to store cannot happen. And now, you also have mortuaries where dead bodies are. This could be a source of outbreak. And so we want to plead with Electricity Corporation of Ghana and NETCO not to disconnect facilities.
So let's look at the substantive issue of you issuing threat. Some of your members are issuing threat that if effective March 2020, the government doesn't honor its obligations to you through the payment of NHIA's claims, you will withdraw your service. I want to ask again, how far has negotiations between your association and the National Health Insurance Authority been in ensuring that you're paid what is owed you?
Let me mention that CHAG, we have a policy of non-strike, and we have not stated that we want to go on strike. It's not been our stance.
But you are threatening?
No, that is not CHAG. Okay. As much as possible, we always adopt non-strike approach, and we want to emphasize it. We want to work with the government, we want to work with National Health Insurance. What is to be done should be done, so that we don't get to that point.
So if you say you have not, why are we getting the impression? Maybe some of your members are frustrated because the association doesn't seem to have a unified front when it comes to putting pressure on government to ensure you get what is due you.
You are talking about Private Health Providers Association.
Okay.
We are not Christian the, Health Association okay. of Ghana. Okay. Okay. We have always had a unified front. We hold the fault for government in places where government facilities are not. We are the people who hold the fault. Majority of the places in BA, we hold the fault in Techiman, in Domahinkro, that serves two countries, Ghana, Cote d'Ivoire, German District, all those places, Wenchi. Those places are all served by CHAG facilities.
So what's going to be the future now? I mean, you keep negotiating, you keep discussing with NHIS whilst the debts are still compounding. There are other debts which have not been paid, and if it goes into 2020, it's going to add up.
Well, we hope that the NHIA will pay very soon. We have had negotiations. We are also working on electronic claim submissions. 2 years ago, we embarked on that project. Almost all our facilities are on electronic claim submission. And we hope that through this forum, the appropriate authorities will hear and reimburse our facilities accordingly.
Right. Doc, we're grateful for your time. Thank you very much.